Good afternoon, everyone. I would like to speak on the scriptures and how the scriptures have helped me understand Jesus Christ better and his atonement. I would just like to start by saying that Jesus Christ and seminary has been such a blessing in my life. It's given me such a deeper understanding of God's plan for me and my family and everything. I just want everyone to know it's worth the lack of sleep, and it's kind of hard, but I'm glad that I did it, and I'm glad that my parents were persistent on me doing it and made a way for me to do it. I'd like to think that it was a little bit of divine intervention that I was able to make it to seminary every day, but on a serious note, there's nothing that can replace seminary and studying for 4 years. A gospel truth that I got from my student manual says, "The Lord responds to our genuine desire to draw closer to him." So as we strive to go to seminary and study our scriptures, he'll listen to our genuine desire. President Monson describes seminary as the goal of the gospel teachings is not to pour information into the minds of the learners. The aim is to inspire individuals to think about, feel about, and then do something about living the gospel. So I think that goes perfect with seminary, because you can sit in seminary and learn and get all the information, but until you do something about it and living it is what really matters. In the scriptures teach that faith in the Lord Jesus Christ and repentance are the two enabling powers of the atonement. In Alma 32:21, faith in Jesus Christ is a hope for all, for things which are not seen, which are true. Another quote from my student manual says, faith must be centered in Jesus Christ in order for it to lead a person to salvation. Having a faith in Jesus Christ means relying completely on him and trusting in his infinite atonement, power, and love. It includes believing that even though we don't understand all things, he does. This past year in seminary, we studied the Book of Mormon, and one of the greatest examples of faith to me was the 2,000 stripling warriors. And in Alma 52:21, it says the warriors obeyed with exactness. They believed and followed God's commandments and their power and their parents with exactness. They believed they had perfect faith in God's plan. So like when they were going to battle, they didn't fear death, because God gave them that He promised them and assured them that they would be safe as long as they trusted in the Lord and they obeyed the commandments. The second enabling power is repentance. And repentance is a change of heart. It's turning from your sins and turning to the Lord for forgiveness. True repentance is motivated by the love of God and wanting to follow His commandments. My sister brought to my attention that the commandments if you break the commandments, it's bad and everything, but it hurts God more than it hurts you. And they're just there to keep us safe, and we should follow because God gave them to us to keep us safe. And when we sin, we are cut off from God, and we become unclean. In 3 Nephi 27:19, it says, "No unclean thing can dwell in the kingdom of heaven." So we must atone for our sins so that we can return to live with Heavenly Father, because that's really the main goal of this life, is so that we can return to live with Him. And the atonement is the only way that we can receive everlasting life. In the scriptures, in Isaiah, it teaches that Jesus Christ has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows and was wounded for our transgressions. This is just so great, because He is the reason we can return to live with our Heavenly Father, and without Him we couldn't. And a quote by Elder Holland puts it perfectly, our main purpose is to return to Jesus, to live with Jesus Christ and Heavenly Father. And he says, that is why we make solemn covenants based on Jesus Christ, atoning sacrifice. And that is why we take upon his name in as many ways as possible, both figuratively and literally. We try to take upon us his identity. We seek out his teachings and recall his miracles. We send Latter-day Witnesses around the world to declare his message. We call ourselves his children and testify that he is the only source of eternal life. We plead for him to swing open the gates of heaven in our behalf and trust everlasting that he will based on our faithfulness. I'd just like to close with my testimony and how much the scriptures and the prophets have strengthened it. And by studying the scriptures in seminary these past 4 years, I've learned so much about Christ and his ministry and his love for all of his children. And this has made me have such faith in God's plan of happiness and eternal families. One of my greatest accomplishments would be graduating this morning. And I'd like to thank my parents and my teachers and Mimi for being my seminary teacher for 3 years. And Sister Eccles for being my seminary teacher this past year. And I say these things in English, Christ, amen.